Good morning, dear students. Owing to the COVID-19 pandemic, Martham Higher Secondary School Indore takes pleasure of commencing the online classes for you. The lockdown situation has had an adverse impact on teaching learning process. So without hampering it further, let's begin our online classes for your academic benefit. You are advised to revise the content thoroughly and solve the worksheet provided properly. Dear students, as it is written in the Holy Scripture, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him I will trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. I convey my best wishes and prayer for the upcoming session. Dear students, take care of your health and stay safe. May God bless us all. Thank you.
Hello students. Welcome to the new session 2021. My name is Pratibha Agarwal. I am your English teacher. Today I am going to teach you English grammar. Today's topic is past tense. Here you can see the classification of past tense. Past simple, past continuous, past perfect and the past perfect continuous tense. First, I will tell you what is past simple tense. It indicates an action that happened in the past. That means work has completed. That is called past simple tense. Here you can see the structure of affirmative sentence of past simple tense. First, we'll take subject plus verb to plus object. Here you can see the example of affirmative sentence. He went to school. They sang a song. Let's see. He and they are subject. And went and sang, second form of the verb. And last one is school and song is object. Now let's move towards negative sentence. Here you can see the structure of negative sentence. Subject plus did plus not plus verb 1 plus object. For example, he did not go to school. They did not sing a song. Again here you can see he and they are subject. They did not sing a song. You have to put not after did for making negative sentence. One thing you have to keep in mind, after putting did, you have to take first form of the verb. Now let's move towards interrogative sentence. Here you can see the structure of interrogative sentence. Did plus subject plus verb 1 plus object. For example, did he go to school? Did they sing a song? Here you can see did helping verb in the starting when we make interrogative sentence. And you always keep in mind you have to put question mark at the end of the sentence for making interrogative sentence. Now let's move toward past continuous tense. It indicates an action that was happening for a length of time in the past. Here you can see the structure of affirmative sentence of past continuous tense. Subject was verb plus verb 1 plus ing plus object. For example, he was going to school. They were singing a song. Here you can see he and they are subject. And was verb are helping verb. And singing and going are the ing form of the verb. And last one, school and song are object. Now let's move towards negative sentence. Here you can see the structure of negative sentence of past continuous tense. Subject was verb plus verb 1 plus not plus ing plus object. For example, he was not going to school. They were not singing a song. Here you can see, after helping verb that are was verb, you have to put not for making negative sentence. Now let's move towards interrogative sentence. Here you can see the structure of interrogative sentence of past continuous tense. Was verb plus subject plus verb 1 plus ing plus object. For example, was he going to school? Were they singing a song? Here you can see was verb are helping verb in the starting while making interrogative sentence, and you have to put question mark at the end of the sentence. Now let's move towards past perfect tense. It indicates an action that had happened. Here you can see the structure of affirmative sentence of past perfect tense. Subject plus had plus verb 3 plus object. For example, he had gone to school. They had sung a song. Here you can see he and they are subject. You always take subject in the starting and after that helping verb, that is had, and third form of the verb that are gone and sung, and last one is object, school and song. Now let's move towards negative sentence. Here you can see the structure of negative sentence of past perfect tense. Subject plus had plus not plus verb 3 plus object. For example, he had not gone to school. They had not sung a song. Here you can see he and they are subject. Had is helping verb and gone and sung a third form of the verb, and school and song are object. Now let's move towards interrogative sentence. Here you can see the structure of interrogative sentence of past perfect tense. Had plus subject plus verb 3 plus object. For example, had he gone to school? Had they sung a song? Here you can see helping verb that is had in the starting while making interrogative sentence, and you have to put question mark at the end of the sentence for making interrogative sentence. Now let's move past perfect continuous tense. It indicates an action that had been happening. Here you can see the affirmative sentence of past perfect continuous tense. Here you can see the structure. Subject had plus been plus verb 1 plus ing plus object. For example, he had been going to school. They had been singing a song. Here you can see he and they are subject. Had been is helping verb, and going and singing are verb 1 plus ing form of the verb, and school and song are object. Now let's move towards negative sentence. Here you can see the structure of negative sentence of past perfect continuous tense. Subject had plus not plus been plus verb 1 plus ing plus object. For example, he had not been going to school. They had not been singing a song. Here you can see you have to put not after helping verb, that is had, for making negative sentence. Now let's move towards interrogative sentence. Here you can see the structure of interrogative sentence of past perfect continuous tense. Had plus subject plus been plus verb 1 plus ing plus object. For example, had he been going to school, had they been singing a song. Here you can see had in the starting for making interrogative sentence, and you have to put question mark at the end of the sentence while making interrogative sentence. So that's all for today. I hope you understood.